I think when they first told us that he had cancer, just shook the whole household. Now we got different plans, we got different goals. The average goals that the regular family have and their basic problems, the problems that we wish we had.
Hi, I'm Ashley.
And I'm Nate, and we're Ayden's parents.
Ayden is the oldest of three. We do have three boys. He's 6 years old. He's very active. He's very
energetic. It was like the fall of 2023. We were trick-or-treating and he just wasn't for it. He was ready to go home and lay down.
When we went to the emergency room, they did their tests, CT scans. They didn't see anything, you know, wrong with Ayden. So they just told us, okay, just take him home. He's probably just having some pain. His leg is growing pains. That's what they called them. We gave them some Tylenol at home to just try to ease the pain, but it never got better. It just honestly got worse.
And I would say maybe like a week after the Halloween was when we were visiting up here in Northwest Indiana.
He was watching his iPad on the couch and I can kind of tell like his words were getting a little slower. Then at that point, he just fell on the ground. He couldn't stand anymore, so.
Yeah, then I just picked him up and just straight to the hospital.
They did tell me that they're not equipped enough for Ayden. We got transferred to Commerce Hospital that night.
Which is in Chicago.
The doctors did pull us both aside and,
yeah, and that's when we found out that it was cancer.
He had his biopsy while he was in the ICU, and it came back a couple days, which was November 16th. That's when it came back that he was positive for high-risk neuroblastoma. What do you do next? Like, literally in my heart, it felt like my world had just dropped on the ground. I remember me crying for weeks.
Just shook the whole household.
We decided that we needed to move back down, you know, closer to our support system and where he's gonna receive his treatment at. My mom, she had to help us support our, cause I did have a 2-year-old son at that point. He was two, his name was Nakeem.
Right, and she was pregnant with our now 1-year-old. Yeah. So it was really just ultimately
a lot.
And we had family members participating and helping us with our younger children.
He started off having 4 cycles of high-dose chemo. And then after that, we did the surgery. Right after that, we jumped into chemo immunotherapy. And that was like the bridge to the stem cell transplant. Then we did the immunotherapy and he responded very well with the immunotherapy.
Yep, almost wiped it completely
yes,
out.
Yes, and then after that was what we are at now, his DFMO, which is his maintenance drug.
As he was going through his treatments, he dealt with a lot of fatigue, loss of energy, loss of appetite, and nausea.
It was a point where I had to feed Ayden through a tube because he just would not eat.
Well, one thing I would like to share for anybody that's going through a cancerous situation to just stay positive, and because I know how easy it is to feel like your situation is beating you.
When he initially got his test results back that he was still cancer-free, which was in April of this year, we had a party for him in July. And that's when he was able to just be a kid again. He's doing great. He is thriving.
I was sick. I was at the hospital and the doctor made me feel better.
He's only 6, so he still has like a whole lot of life to live. But I would say if any mother would hope that their child be free, you know, be able to be a child, be able to live his life without the burden of having cancer on his shoulders, a healthy life.
No child, regardless of funding, expenses, should have to go without getting their treatments.
The fact that they're coming up with, you know, the cures or the treatments alone, I just feel like that's the best thing anyone could do. I just want to, if I have to say, you know, to the researchers, I would honestly thank them. Like, you really saved my child's life. Funding for cancer research means, you know, giving families and their children a fighting chance, not just for survival, though, for living a full and, you know, healthy life.
I'm gonna go fight.